Hi and welcome back, it's Vicky here and today I'm going to play with new stamps and dies to create a lovely winter scene card. I will be working with the Snow Buddies stamp set. This is new by MFD, it's from their November release. And if you want to check out the whole release, I did do an unboxing video which I posted today. I will link it to the end of this one. So I'm stamping my images and I picked up the girl, the little dog, as well as the fence. I'm stamping it a couple of times with my Misty to get a good impression, and I'm using an extreme black ink by MFD. To color my images, I'm going to use my alcohol markers. Of course, you can use any color combo that you love and any color medium that you want. And depending on the color combo that you decide to use, it can easily turn into a holiday card. For example, you can use greens and reds. However, I decided to keep it winter themed. I'm securing the matching dies on top so that I can cut them out and pop them on my card. And this stamp set is my absolute favorite from the whole release. I think all the images there are super cute. This is where I decided that I want to have some snowballs, so that's why I'm going to stamp them now. And then place the die on top as well so that I can cut out all the images with one pass. Now I'm securing everything down with purple tape, which is a low tack tape. And since I'm going to do all the die cutting now, I will also use this die set. This is called Snowy Hillside. I'm going to cut out all these dies and I will use white cardstock. But this is a very versatile die set. Instead of using white for snow, you can always use green and have grass and green trees for your scenes. So I ran through everything through my Spellbinders machine and now I'm going to pop all the images and I'm ready to put my card together. For my background I will use this blue cardstock. This is 4 by 5 1/4, so it is a quarter smaller in every dimension, and this is going to give a lovely border when I stick that on top of my card base. I'm adding splashes all over the place. These are going to look like snow, and I'm using white gesso diluted with water. I'm going to use tape runner at the back of the bigger slope and I'm going to stick it completely flat on top of my background. And of course you can use foam tape at the back of that if you want to add even more dimension. Now for the second slope I'm going to go with foam tape at the back and stick it in place as well. And you can see I end up having a lovely dimension. Now all I have to do is to decide where all the other elements are going to go. So I'm going to play a little bit with the placement. And once I decide what looks pleasing to the eye, I will start sticking everything down. For some of the images I'm going to use my tape runner, so they are going to go completely flat. And for others I'm going to use foam squares at the back, like this little tree, for more dimension. I placed the fence flat in between the two slopes and now on top I'm going to place the little girl. She has foam squares at the top of her, so she is leveled with the first layer of snow. And the little doggy is going to go completely flat on top. Now I do have to stick down the little snowballs in front of the dog, and my little scene is pretty much ready. All I have to do is to add the sentiment. And from the same stamp set, I used the one that says "You are a flurry of fun," which I stamped with black ink on white cardstock. I used one of my fishtail sentiment dies to cut it out. And finally, I'm using my tape runner at the back and I'm going to stick it on top of my card base. That's 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. And I'm going to call this card done. You will find links to everything I used down below in the description area. And here are some close-up photos on this adorable winter card. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment down below and also like and subscribe if you haven't done so already. Thank you all so much for watching today and I'll see you all next time.